Hey yo, welcome to Astronaut. Today is all about the ways in which stars transfer heat, radiation, and convection. I feel like an astronaut in what you know about rolling down in the deep. Heat transfer is the process in which energy is generated and moved from one location to another. There are three main forms of heat transfer: conduction, convection, and radiation. Conduction occurs between particles that are densely packed. Heat is transferred via contact between particles. Convection involves the movement of fluids. Fluids near a hot surface move away from the source of heat into cooler layers, and the cooler layers move into hot layers. As temperatures increase, hot molecules expand, lose density, and rise, displacing the cooler molecules above them. Eventually, these molecules will cool down as well and stop moving upward. Radiation is the third type of heat transfer and occurs when electromagnetic radiation is emitted from a source and absorbed by a different surface. Some people also list evaporation as a fourth type of heat transfer because a lot of energy is required for a liquid molecule to turn into a gas. However, convection and radiation are the most important forms of heat transfer within stars. Why not conduction? Well, conduction is a particularly slow method of heat transfer and is not very efficient for most stars, since conduction requires molecules to be in close proximity to one another and the molecules within stars are not very densely packed. Conduction, however, comes back into play once a star stops fusing and turns into a compact object, like a white dwarf. So when are stars convective and when are they radiative? Well, a star will opt for whichever is more efficient. This is dependent on opacity and the energy-temperature relationship. Opacity is a term to describe how well a material can scatter and absorb photons. When a material regularly absorbs photons, which occurs to ionize atoms, it has a high opacity. If a material absorbs photons easily, the photons will have a difficult time passing through the material, and thus heat transfer via radiation will be inefficient. In this case, when the opacity is high, convection takes over. The outer layers of low-mass stars are not hot enough to ionize hydrogen. Hydrogen ionization takes place around 10,000 Kelvin. Because of this, hydrogen absorbs photons in the outer envelopes of low-mass stars, making the opacity high. Radiation is inefficient in this region, so convection takes over. By contrast, the outer layers of high-mass stars are very hot, so hydrogen stays ionized in these regions and does not need to absorb photons. Because there is no need to absorb photons here, the outer layers of high-mass stars have a low opacity, and thus radiative transport can take place. Another important aspect of determining which method of heat transfer is most efficient is energy transport. If significantly more energy is produced than is able to flow out of a region, radiation will struggle to sustain energy balance, so convection takes over. That means convection dominates when the rate of energy production changes rapidly. Low-mass stars have an energy-temperature dependence of E is proportional to T to the fourth. This comes from the PP chain. Radiation can operate under this energy fluctuation, so the cores of low-mass stars run on a radiative transport. Massive stars, on the other hand, have an energy-temperature dependence of E is proportional to T to the 20th. This comes from the CNO cycle. This energy flux is too steep for radiation to handle, so convection takes over heat transfer in the core of massive stars. Okay, let's review. Most stars have both convective and radiative layers to conduct heat transfer. Where conduction and radiation occur within the star is dependent on the opacity and energy-temperature relationship within different sections of the star. Low to intermediate mass stars, that is from about 0.5 to 1.5 solar masses, have a radiative layer enveloped by a convective layer. The convective zone occupies the outer 30% of the Sun, by radius, from 0 to about 200,000 kilometers deep, which we can see in this image from NASA. We could go into the specifics of how to calculate where exactly convection dominates radiation, and vice versa, but I think that's too much for one video, so I would rather save the heavy math for a follow-up video. Before you begin working with the equations for heat transfer, it's good to have a conceptual understanding of what you should expect in different stars. Some stars, think less than 0.5 solar masses, are so cool that the convective envelope extends throughout the entire star. Lastly, massive stars have a convective layer enveloped by a radiative layer. Well, I hope this helped introduce or clarify the topic of heat transfer in stars. I'll make a note of where you can access more info regarding the equations of heat transfer, including any follow-up content I create, in the description of this video. Until then, ponder, wander, and go right in the stars. In slow motion, yeah. I feel like an astronaut.